Welcome to Now We Know Tarot, daily encouragement and more from the Gnosis Hostess with the Mostess.
Yay! Yay! Yay!
Only use what amuses. We're using the Rider Tarot deck and the Wheel of Fortune Tarot and other various etc. etc. decks to be determined throughout the reading. What do we now know for the collective? Oh dear tarot. First, we have the Ace of Cups. Second, we have the Ten of Cups. And third, we have the Six of Swords in reverse. Dun, dun, dun. Well, it's been rough, but happiness appears and love will happen. I'm reading this storyline in reverse. So, there's a love offer. And it makes a happy rainbow streak across the sky, bringing everything emotionally fulfilling and a closeness and a comfort. And yet, it still somehow is not correct. It causes a whole lot of
ripples.
And we have the Queen of Swords showing her ugly ass face once more. Like, will you ever go away? Very cruel, very calculated, very off. Very off. This person is off. Off their rocker. In a very bad way. It feels like their energy is amped up. It feels like they've told themselves all kinds of narratives that are delusional, and they think that they are everything when they are not. So, you want to be the person who works on your self-love and sees the silver lining in everything and stays relatively grounded and protected, because there's something happening that we need to explore here that is not good. Not good, honey. It's not good. All right, so tell us about the Ace of Cups. Somebody's really happy. The Queen of Swords, the Page of Wands. These two are like the friends that take people down. We all know them. And then we have the Queen of Pentacles, the long-suffering good person. Who's feeling the love here? The Queen of Swords does not have feelings. The Page of Wands is the troublemaker. And the Queen of Pentacles is like, I'm just getting through this. Don't mess with me, darling. Okay? Tell us about this Ten of Cups, which is everything that you ever wanted, needed, or desired. Ten of Pentacles, a legacy. Seven of Cups, a fuckery. And the Chariot, progress. The go-ahead goes on ahead. Even if there are ghosts and baggage of the past, we have to have this satisfaction here. Ten of Cups, Ten of Pentacles. This is someone's due. This is someone's destiny. This is someone's reward. But other people are subterfuging, and you need to hurry forward past the idiots. Tell us about this situation. Upside down, Six of Swords is a big brouhaha. The Seven of Wands in reverse. Temperance. And the Ten of Wands. Someone let their guard down. They need to balance it out because it's too much. Can this Queen of Pentacles stay balanced in the midst of people who don't have their best interests at heart and illusions being cast when they're not really guarding themselves all that well and they're on overload? That is the question. Underneath the deck, we have the Nine of Pentacles. See, there's some feminine energy that is undermining this person who has steadfastly done everything correctly. With great effort, they're showing up for their great reward, and it just goes upside down. Don't drink or use any kind of substance if you're in recovery, or you know you can't handle it, or you really shouldn't. Keep going no matter what. The Queen of Pentacles keeps going no matter what. The Queen of Pentacles is like the marathon stamina of the abundance of the universe. They write themselves through the wrongness and stay absolutely solid. It's like a superhero here. Now I'm going to select three of these when in hell. Okay. And three of these yes and no. And three of these real B affirmations with attitude. Because it's like a wink wink situation. There's a lot not being said. There's a lot being done, and there's big messes to clean up in this entire scenario. Firstly, it says, inhale love, exhale BS. Patience is needed. Yes. You're going to have a really good honeymoon period filled with warmth and joy. When you first get together with someone, even if they're flawed, even if they have bad people around them, your view of the situation is going to be one of inner harmony. And it's because you feel invincible. The timing on this is 2 to 3 weeks. You're very dynamic, persuasive, and you achieve your goals. Okay? You're inhaling. This is time for you to bring it in for yourself. That's the first card. The second card, and that was the Ace of Cups, by the way, which is a blessed time period, a new beginning of love. Then the second card, which is fruition and, you know, a maturation of devotion, I'll call it, with the, you know, everything great, even if there are these situations, it says, let go of the S and don't feel guilty. Yes, fortune is on your side. You're the streak of positivity in the day-to-day. Everything is incredibly easy and joyful for you. Nothing's touching you. Nothing's sticking. All the negativity just bounces back. This is in the next 2 to 4 months. And the more unpredictable life gets, the better it is. The outcome is awe-inspiring and kind of dramatical. Okay. Then we have this reverse six. Which is a lot of writing that doesn't really make sense. Like the words are all chopped up. It might be word salad. What I'm getting here is somebody having karma that makes them not their normal self in regards to communication. And I'm going to leave it at that. What it's supposed to say is, I celebrate the S. But why would someone in their right mind be celebrating when they put a wrench in something? They're only harming themselves. And we have yes. Knock, knock. Good luck at the door. To clarify the unclear, stagnation and failure vanish as the proverbial door opens wide for a rich and beautiful life. And this is within the next 3 to 5 months. You have inspiration, enthusiasm, and your future self thanks you. So what I see here is a progression in the start of a new love, 2 to 3 weeks. Being forbearing and kind, and having a lot of good fortune as a result in 2 to 4 months. And then in 3 to 5, even though someone tries to sabotage, you still open the door to even further happiness. May I repeat that again? More opportunity comes to you despite anyone doing anything who gets instant karma instantly, while you enjoy your happiness for a long while. And that is what we now know from the tarot today. Thank you, and namaste.